from the subject, run that you might obtain. Run that you might obtain. Paul, in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, I'll begin in verse 1, but we're not going to read all of that. But this is where we pick up with this particular thought here. And he says, am I not an apostle? Am I not free? Have I not seen Jesus Christ our Lord? Or not be my work in the Lord? If I be not an apostle unto others, yea, doubtless I am to you, for the seal of my apostleship are you in the Lord. My answer to them that do examine me in this, have we not power to eat and to drink? So Paul here answers some things that some critics had thrown his way. But he goes down through this particular text, and he talks about how he has sown spiritual things and how he should be allowed to reap carnal things. He say things like, do you not know in verse 13 that they which minister by holy things live of the things of the temple, and they which wait at the altar are partakers with the altar? Even so hath the Lord ordained that they which preach the gospel should live of the gospel. But I have used none of these things, neither have I read these things, that it should be so done unto me, for it were better for me to die than the inner man should make my glory void. But though I preach the gospel, I have nothing to glory of, for necessity is laid upon me. Yea, it warns me if I preach not the gospel. So Paul continues to go down and say, you know what, the things that you guys are talking about, they're really not bothering me, they really don't concern me. Paul says, I am here for the explicit purpose, with the explicit intent of trying to save the soul. Paul says, all these other things don't mean anything to me. So he jumps down to verse 21. He says, to them that are without the law, as without the law, he said how he had become certain, took on certain personas in certain ways in order to reach and to win those who were lost. So Paul says, all this other stuff you all are talking about, it doesn't faze me, because I'm talking about the saving of the souls. We spoke about that this morning, how important our souls are. So he says, being without the law to God, but under the law to Christ, that I might gain them that are without law. He says, so to the weak, verse 22, became I as weak, that I might gain the weak. He said, I made all things to all men, that I might by all means save some. Paul said, I'm not going to compromise the gospel, the teachings, but I will come down to where you are, or I will rise up to where you are, in order to meet you, that I may be able to teach you about those things pertaining to your soul's salvation. And he says, in all of this that I do, for the gospel's sake, that I might be partaker thereof with you. Paul said, I want to share in that, we sing that song, I want to be at the meeting, amen, when all the saints get home. Paul says, I want to be at the meeting when the saints get home. And we sing that song when the saints go marching in. Paul says, I want to be there with the saints. I want you to be with me. Amen. Amen. What I'm doing is for your benefit. Not that I may gain anything, but what I'm doing for your benefit. So he says, and this I do, verse 23, for the gospel's sake, that I might be partaker thereof with you. And then he says, let me explain it to you like this. Because I want to talk to you from the subject, run that you might obtain. So in verse 24 is where I really want to focus on. I just want you to see how it got to this. Also, all of this that I'm talking about is because I want you to be where I am, because I'm trying to be where Jesus is. Amen. So it says in verse 24, here's what it's going to take. He says, know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receive the prize. So run that you may obtain. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. He said, therefore, so run, not as uncertainly, so fight I, not as one that beateth the air. But I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest that by any means, when I preach to others, I myself should be a cast away. One thing that will guarantee that you lose a race And that, brothers and sisters, is that if you never set out to run it.
Amen.
You can go and get in any marathon or any race that you can find, and I guarantee you, you will lose if you never set out to run the race. Mm-hmm. So in order to win a race, one must first and foremost be in the race. Mm-hmm. You have to be actively involved. So Paul says here, know ye not that they which run in the race run all, but one receiveth the prize. Now I want to set this up and talk about this prize that he's referring to here. You see, the New Testament Greek, Stephanos, means either a wreath given to the winning athlete or a Greek game or a crown. And we sing that song, Mansion, Robe, and Crown. That crown symbolized a victory. It symbolized overcoming. It symbolized a prize, something that has been achieved or acquired, something that has been won. So they understood what Paul was talking about. So anytime Paul speaks about the Stephanos, this crown, the readers understood where he was coming from. And when we talk about our Olympic athletes, they run for the purpose of winning the gold medal. Amen. It's okay if you get the silver. It's okay if you get the bronze. You got more than what I got. Amen. But they're setting out. They're doing all that for the purpose of obtaining the gold medal. And as we set out on this race that we are in, as we have stepped out on faith, we are pursuing a crown, a Stephanos, this crown. So Paul here, he says in verse 24, know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize. In order to get this prize, there are some things, in order to get this crown, there are some things that we have to do, and I believe that is necessary in order for us to achieve this crown. Amen. Now, I want us to run, not to lose, amen, not to simply say that I was in the race, and we've got this politically correct world we're in now. You remember we used to compete, and the winner received, amen, the prize. Mm-hmm. Now they have what they call a Buck Curry participation. Mm-hmm. You came in number 100, and you get the same trophy that I got, and I came in number 1. Well, how is that helping you? By turning me, oh, y'all ain't gonna go, okay. But we set out, we want to win, amen. We set out to obtain, and that word obtain means to get. It means to acquire or secure something. It means to gain it or to earn it. So I come in first, you come in 100, I get the same. Did you earn it or did I earn what you earned? Help me with that one. It means to achieve or to attain. So when one sets out in a race, they must have a goal in mind. So in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 24, Paul says here, know you not that they which run in a race run all, but one receive the prize. So run that you may obtain. If you never get in the race, you're never going to win. If you are not a child of God, you can't make it to heaven. You can't make it to heaven on the merits of your family, of your loved ones, of your background, amen, of your fame, whether it's good fame or whether it's because of your infamous or something, amen. You have to make it on your own, amen. So you have to get in the race. And you get in the race for the purpose of obtaining or receiving, that you may win. You have to have a goal in mind. He says in verse 24, know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receive the prize, so run that you may obtain. If you never get in the race, you can never. to win. Amen. There's something else about this race. And we talk about this, we call it the walk sometimes. But it's really a race. And there are races where you actually what? Walk. Amen. Now, some of y'all probably beat me on a 100-yard dash. And let's say I want a 5-mile walk. I get you, brother John. Amen. I get you in that 5 miles, you may beat me in that 100, amen. But if I never get in the race, I can't expect to win. And in order to win, I must recognize what the goal is. What is the end result that I'm trying to achieve? I want my crown. And as I know that, I get into the race. In 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 25, Paul says, "And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now they do it to obtain a corruptible crown." He's talking about that crown there. But he says, "But we an incorruptible, Stephanos." In order to win, when I get in that race, it's going to take discipline, amen, and I must be in shape. Now, how do we become disciplined? How do we get in shape in order to win this race that we're running? By being at home with the rest of the saints on Sunday evening. By being 11 o'clock worshipers. By not even knowing that we have Wednesday night Bible study or Tuesday 11 o'clock Bible study. By avoiding every time we have a home Bible study, when we have a gospel reading, by making sure that I have something else to do. That's not how we get in shape. We get in shape by taking every opportunity that we can get to work out. Brother Dwayne, fitness 24/7, man. Brother Wayne said, "I'm gonna wake up." You fitness 24/7?
Yeah.
Yeah. Wayne, he goes to the gym and is open all night. You ain't got no excuse on that one. You can't try, man. Ain't got time. It's open 24/7. You can't find time to work out. We have to work out. We have to want to have God's word as a part of our life. We have to, 2 Timothy 2:15 says, study. That's how we get in shape. We don't have to go out there and run 10 miles a week in order to win this race that we are in, but we do have to study. We have to be disciplined. We have to be temperate. We have to be self-controlled. Do you not know that it takes self-control, it takes discipline in order to study God's word to get what we need to be? Yeah. As much as I love you all, you're not going to get it all here in a few minutes. So we have to study on our own. We have to study to take advantage of every opportunity that the leadership has put in place for us to come together and study God's word. Bible study, Bible class, whatever the case may be. Study. And we're studying 2 Timothy 2:15. Why? To show ourselves approved, not to man. I'm not studying to show you how much I know. I'm studying that God may say, "Hey, you're on the right track." And just when I think I've studied enough, guess what? I need to study some more. We have to study. We have to be disciplined, and we have to be in shape in order to win this race. Another thing about winning this race, we have to be convicted and determined of our end. In 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 26, Paul says, "I therefore so run, not as uncertainly, so fight I not as one that beateth the air." Paul's a little. Paul's a man, that's a certain way to run. Amen. Y'all see those Olympic runners? They take advantage of everything. No step is wasted. You don't see them out there running and all backwards and all kind of sideways and stuff and trying to flip in the air. They have a certain technique. They're certain about every step. No wasted effort. Everything about them is discipline. That's how they rise to the top of their particular field. And if we want to make heaven our home, we have to rise. Amen. Amen. We have to be in shape. We have to be disciplined. We have to know what our end is. We can't waste a lot of time on junk. Amen. I'm going to say that if y'all don't say amen. But we spend a lot of time on junk. get past the junk. We try to save our souls. I'm not gonna get entangled in a bunch of junk and lose my soul. So if you don't want to be part of a bunch of junk, let me tell you, this is from Brother Bishop, this ain't from nobody else. We don't have time for a bunch of junk. We will address serious issues, but we don't have time for a bunch of junk. And sometimes, brothers and sisters, we can come up with junk. It's distracting us, and that's all the devil wants. Yeah, right. The devil says, you see what I'm doing over here? Why are we looking over there?
Right.
We're over here losing our soul.
That's right.
Amen. Let's deal with the serious issues and go to heaven. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Let's not allow people to distract us, our family members, our situations. Do you not know the devil that you can be distracted by even things like your health? Jesus, don't be overly concerned, amen. Mm-hmm. Jesus, why worry about certain things, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's about taking thoughts, you can't have a cure. He said, God knows what you're dealing with. Mm-hmm. Seek the way in matters, amen. Yeah. That's how we're going to make heaven our home.
Yeah.
So he says, therefore run, not as uncertain. He said, so fight I, not as one that beat the arrow. He said, but watch this one here Paul talks about. And in our mind, we can imagine those Olympic runners. He said, I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest it by any means, when I preach to others, I myself should be a castaway. Paul said, know what you're doing. Stay focused. Know what your end goal is. Don't be distracted by a lot of stuff. Look at the prize. And then he says this as I close. Philippians chapter 2, verse 14 through 16, Paul says, you ever see somebody running on a treadmill? Tell you what, you want to lose a race? You get on a treadmill, and we're going to race 100 yards. And it may take me all day, but I guarantee I'll still beat you. But you know what you're doing on a treadmill? Just running your place. You might get out of me on that treadmill. I'll stop and sit down and drink some water, and you still won't pass me up. Don't run this race in vain. In Philippians chapter 2, verse 14, he says, do all things without murmurs and disputings, that you may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom you shine as lights in the world, holding forth the word of life, that I may rejoice at the day of Christ, that I have not run in vain, neither labored in vain. Listen, don't let our race be run in vain. And that's an old song. I can't remember exactly how it goes, but it talks about not running this race in vain. I don't want to win this race in vain. I don't want to have run this entire race and then find out that I'm not even going to receive my status. That'd be a sad day. Because that also involves, Jesus said, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. So don't run the race in vain, but run it with patience. Run it with patience. In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1, one of my favorite texts. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1, as I close here. The Hebrew writer says, wherefore, seeing we also are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us. And here's what's going to keep me focused. I have to have someone to focus on. And as much as we love one another, we can't focus on one another only and expect to go to heaven. Amen. We have to focus on Jesus, because if we just focus on one another, we're going to get sidetracked. And in some cases, we may never come back to the course. We will veer off course, and in some cases, we may never come back. But if we stay focused on Jesus, because he has already run, he has already obtained, and he's already sitting on the right hand of the Father. And if I'm trying to get where he is, I need to focus on antagonist when they brought that woman to him in John chapter 8. So we call her the very act of adultery. She said, okay. Moses said, we also stoned. What do you say? Okay. After a while, it started coming to them. Jesus said, he that without sin, let him cast the first stone. They started to wise it up. And the old man kind of took out that first man. Took a little dumb young boy a little while to get it. But when they did get it, they left. And Jesus said, one word, thine accusers. He says, there's none that accuse me, Lord. He said, neither do I go and sin no more. Listen. We have to stay focused on Jesus. He says, lay aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us. And let us run with patience the race that is set before us. We have to stay focused on Jesus. And then we have to look unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross. See, Jesus never got sidetracked. Jesus had these little, small dogs, and yap yap, always barking at your heel. Chihuahua, yeah, them little things. Bam, bam, barking at you, snap at your heel, they ain't gonna do nothing. Jesus had those all the time in the form of the Pharisees and Sadducees, just nipping and barking at him all the time, and he never got sidetracked. You know why? Because he was focused. He was focused on the mission of the Father. He says, I need to know about the Father's business. So he stayed focused. And he made heaven. He went back to heaven. He's on the right hand of the throne of God. And now we're looking at him. And we're trying to get there. So we have to run this race with patience. Why? Because we want our mansion, our robe, and our crown. In 2 Timothy 4:8. 2 Timothy 4:8 is a close here. It says this, henceforth, Paul says, there's laid up for me a crown of Stephanos, a crown of righteousness which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all of them also that love his appearing. Paul says, I'm seeking. There's a crown set there, Stephanos, set there for me, it's waiting for me. He says, I want my crown. And there's this unfading crown of glory, 1 Peter 5:4. In James 1:12 and Revelation 2:10, it talks about the crown of life. He says here, be thou faithful unto death. Revelation 2:10, and I will give thee the crown of life. Don't you want your crown? Don't you want your mansion, your robe, and your crown? Jesus says, in my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive unto myself. And where I am, make me also. Don't you want to go to heaven? Don't you want to see your mansion, your robe, but also your scapulars, your crown? We have to run that you may obtain. Amen. If you never get in the race, you can never expect to win the prize. Get in the race. If you're here tonight and you're not a child of God, I want you to get in the race tonight. Man. Make this your night that you enter this race. And when you're in this race, you're going to have some difficult times. Man. But guess what? You're having them now. Yeah. But the thing about having difficult times in this race, God is there cheering you on. The angels are cheering us on. We're cheering one another on. We're compassionate about such a cloud of witnesses. We think about Elijah. And we think about Moses and all those who have come before us. And they're saying, you can do it. Don't you want to be a part of this race? Don't you want to be a part of the family of God? It's a simple process. You simply have to obey the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus died on the cross. He's buried and rose again the third day. You heard that story? Do you believe it? Are you willing to have a change of mind? That's the good news of the gospel. Are you willing to have a change of mind that's called repentance? Are you willing to confess that you believe he is the Son of God and then go to the water of the buried baptism and have your sins washed away? Receive the gift of the Holy Spirit to rise to walk in newness of life. And then set out on the race, because you're not a child of God, you're not even in this race yet. But then you're in the race of a child of God, and you look unto Jesus, you stay focused on Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. He's sitting on the right hand of the throne of God. He knows what's going on in your life. He's concerned about your well-being. And he said, come unto me. All you can lay in the heavenly lay, and I will be rest. And then we have to be faithful unto death. And this is the part that I like, church. He says, be faithful unto death, Galatians 2:10, and I will give thee what? A crown. I'll be your stepness of life. Don't you want your crown tonight? If you're not a child of God, we want you to come to you tonight. You're a child of God, but you've been distracted. You've been hindered by whatever, for whatever reason. You've gotten tired. Maybe you started off running the race so fast you just feel wore out. Just slow down. Take your time. But stay in the race. Because Jesus says, he that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved. Mm-hmm. If you're here tonight, you're not a child of God, we want you to come. This invitation is yours. If you're here tonight, you're a child of God, we want you to come. We want you to come at this time. Stand, sing, salt, and prayer.